Hello everybody, welcome back to Olympiad School. I hope you are all doing great. In this third part of the video tutorial of IMO previous year question paper 2008 set A for class 5, we'll be discussing about questions through 41 to 50. So the first two parts, you can get the link from the description below or you can find it here in the card section. Okay. So before starting the video, I would like to suggest the students who are watching this video out there to pause the video every time when they come across a new question on the screen, solve of their own, then can note out the answer to check it with the explanations, okay, after playing the video. So with that note, let us start the video, and don't forget to like the video if you really liked it, and share the video with your range, and subscribe the video, press the bell icon below to get all the notifications as and when I come across with a new video for you. Okay, so let us start this session with the question number 41, which says a plumber has 8.5 meter long pipe. He divides it into three parts. The top and bottom part measures 5, 7, 8 meter each. Find the length of the middle part. So for better understanding, let me draw. So let us assume this is the pipe and he divides into three parts. Okay, let it be the first part, let it be the second part, and let it be the third part. So what he is saying is the top and the bottom, the top and the bottom part measures this each. Okay, so that means it is not the sum of both the parts, rather it is 5, 7 by 8, and it is also 5, 7 by 8. Each measures 5, 7 by 8. So find the length of the middle part of the pipe. So we need to find the length of this part, that is the second part. Okay, so for that you need to subtract the sum of this and this from like the total length of the pipe. So I can write it like here in equation for this, like 18.5 minus twice of 5, 7 by 8. So rest of the solutions I have already given. So like 8.5 can be written in the form 37 by 2. Okay, so it is a mixed number, it is a imperfect improper fraction. Okay, so again this 5, 7 by 8 is same as 47 by 8, and this 2 can be cancelled with 8 to get 4. So again these fractions become like 37 by 2 and 47 by 4. So you can again subtract it by taking the LCM, which is 4. Again 4 divided by 2 multiplied with 37 will give 74. And as both of them are 4, so it will after division it will give 1, and you can multiply with 47 to get 47. So it is again 74 minus 47, it is 27 by 4, which is 6 whole 3 by 4. So you can get it from option B. So let's jump on to the next question, which is saying that 15 bags of salt cost 375 rupees. If each bag contains 5 kg of salt, then find the cost of 1 kg of salt. See, this question can be solved easily with two steps. So first step is, like it is saying 15 bags cost 375 rupees. So definitely one bag will cost 15 parts of it. That means you have to divide it by 15. So I would suggest don't go for the long division method, that is the traditional division method. So you can do it right here by just remembering the multiplication table of 15. So it is a very easy one. 15 one time is 15, 15 two times is 30. So it will be 2, and we will have 7 left, and this 5 will make this 7, 75. So it is like 25. See, this 25 is the cost of one bag, but it is again saying that each bag contains 5 kg of salt. So that means it becomes, this one bag is containing 5 kg of salt. So this becomes the cost of 5 kg of salt. So that is, we can say that 5 kg of salt is like worth 25 rupees. So it is, it becomes now very easy. So you can find out the 1 kg cost, like dividing, so you will get 5. So number C is the correct answer. A bakery owner bakes 851 patties every day, out of which he sends 15 patties to his home, 180 patties for orphans, and sells the rest of the patties. So we have to find out the number of patties he will sell in the month of May, which is of 31 days. Okay. So in order to find out the answer, we need to find out how many patties he is not selling. So he is not selling means 180 plus 15, that is 195 number of patties he is not selling. Okay. So like how much is he selling? That means 851 minus 195. So if you subtract 851 195, you will get like 95 plus 5 plus 600 plus 51. So it is like I am going from 195 to 851. So this is a very shortcut method of subtracting, that is you need to make it 851 by supplying the correct number. So first of all, I have like added 5, so it will become like 200, then 600, now it become 800, then 51, 851. So from this you can find out the answer, that is 651 plus 5, 656. So 656 is the number of patties he is selling like daily. So we need to multiply by 31 to get the correct answer. So here we can also apply a short trick, like after finding out the unit place digit. So unit place 1 multiplied by 6, definitely it will give 6. So this may or this may be the answer, but these two cannot be our answer. And if you will closely observe these two numbers, one is 30,000 plus and one is 20,000 plus. So again you can do do an estimation, like suppose make it like 700 and make it like 30. So you will get 7 times, which will be 21, and this will become 21,000. So now you have an idea that our answer cannot exceed 21 or is not much more than 21. So it will be around 21,000. So correct answer will be definitely D. So you can do the rest and find out the correct answer yourself. So next is like a farmer has a rectangular field of dimensions 2500 meter by 155 meter. He plants tomatoes in 1/4 of the total area and plants potatoes in the rest area. So what area has utilized for planting the potatoes? So this is a case of assume that it is the rectangular field. So I'll have to make it 4 parts. So it is used for tomatoes and rest are used for potatoes. So it is clearly understandable, that is, it is 1/4 part of the total area, and for potatoes it is 3/4 part of the total area. So the steps involved to find out the answers are, first we have to find out the total area, then 3/4 of total area. Okay, so let's try to find out. Okay, so the length is like 2500. I have to multiply it by 155. So definitely I will get the total area. So then I have to multiply it with 3/4. So why should I just multiply these big numbers, then I know that I have to divide it by 4. So let us first divide. So 2500 can be written as 25 into 100, so that I can cancel 4 from each side to get 25 here. So this is 25 into 25 into 1, 55 into 3. See, this 3 can be multiplied easily with like 155. So from this part, I will get 25 into 25, that is 625. And 3 times 155 would get like 15, 3 times is 450. And 5, 3 times is again 15. So it will be like 465. So again, it will be like 3 line multiplication. So, and here we will again put some efforts towards the estimation. Okay. So this 5 and 5 will multiplied, so definitely it will give rise to 5 as a like unit place digit. So like this and this cannot be our answer. So our answer can be like this or this. So again, what you can do is you have to find out the at least the tens digit so that it will be confirmed whether A or B is the correct answer. See, so 5 times 5 is 25. So here you have carried 2. Again, like 5 times 2 is like 10 plus 2, 12. So again, you have 2 and carry 1. So we will not do the rest of the multiplication. We will only require the tens place. So I have got the tens place for 5 and I will get the tens place for 6 by multiply 6 into 5, which is 30. So again, 3 0, so 3 will be carried and we will leave the rest of the multiplication. So here we will see that 2 plus 2, okay, 20. So our tens and unit place digits will be definitely 25. So this is cancelled and B is our correct answer. But I would suggest you that you do the whole multiplication and check the answer of yourself. Okay, so let's jump on to the next question, which is question number 45. Question is asking like a box contains 11 muskmelons weighing 255 gram each and 15 mangoes weighing 85 gram each. If the total weight of the box is 5 kg, then what is the weight of the empty box? So there is a box containing muskmelons and mangoes, and the total weight of the box including the fruits is 5 kg. So we can say 5 kg equals to 5000 gram. So in order to find the answer, we need to find the total weight of the mangoes and muskmelon. So let us first find the weight of the muskmelon. So if we'll multiply 255 with 11, then we will get like 5 here, 2 here. So this is a trick I am using. So you have to add these two numbers for the 5 plus 5, 10, that is 0, carry 1, and a pass 2 plus 5 is 7 plus this one, that is 2805. So again, we need to find out 85 into 15. So this is like 85 15 times. So 85 10 times is 850, you know, and 5 times would be it's half, like 425. So total would be like 4 plus 8, 1275. So we can write 1275 here. We will add these two, get the total weight of the fruit. So it is like 10, it is like 8, it is like again 10, it is like 4. So it is like 4080 grams. So subtract 4080 gram from this 5000 gram, we will definitely get 920 gram, which is like option A. So let us jump on to the next question from the achiever section. So the question is asking like to read the following statement carefully and select the correct option. Okay, let us read the first statement correctly and carefully also. So if the greatest 8 digit number is divided by the greatest 3 digit number, then we get 99 as the remainder. So let us write the greatest 8 digit number first. Okay, so this is the greatest 8 digit number and we have to divide it by the greatest 3 digit number. So when you will start dividing with the traditional method, then it will definitely kill a lot of time and you will fall short of time. So for this first 3 digits are required to get the first digit of the question. So it will be like 999999. So it will you can write 1 here. So again, while you will be dividing this 9, it will not be sufficient. So you have to put 0 and it will like become 99. Again, it will not be sufficient. So again, we have to put one more 0. Again, now you are having like 999. So you can divide. So you will get another 1. So again, for these two numbers also, you have to put another 2 zeros. But these 299 will not be divided further. So these two numbers will be like a remainder, become a remainder. So this statement is like true. So again, let us read the statement 2 correctly. So the place value of 5 in this number when divided by the successor of 999 gives 5000. So this is a two phase or three phase question, you can say. So let us find out the like place value of 5. So here 5 is there. So like 5, 6, triple. So 999. So 5000. So this is like 5000. That is 5000 is the place value of 5 when divided by the successor of 999. So you have to divide the number by successor of 999. Successor of 999 is plus 1, like 1000. So if you cancel all the zeros, then you will be having 5. So it can be 5 only, but it is saying that it will be like 5000. So it is a false statement. So you have the first statement as true and the second statement as false. So you need to find out the correct combination. Okay, it is in B, like the statement 1 is true, but the statement 2 is false. So let's jump on to the next question. So it is like you have to simplify this. So I would like to request you to pause the video here to find out the answer of your own. So note down the answer and then come and play the video while I'm explaining. Okay. So here it has been explained. So I have like distributed the whole question into three parts. So the part one is like so half, I have written half, this 3/4 became like 13/2. I have made it improper fraction. And this 1 1/6, 6 times 1 is 6, plus 1 7, 7/6. So again it is improper. So now I have taken the like so denominator, I have taken the LCM. So LCM is 2L. So for getting these numbers, you know, you have to like divide this LCM with each and every denominators, then you have to multiply with the 1. Okay, so first let us try divide by 2. So it will become 6. 6 times 1 is 6. So again divide it by 4. So it will become 3. 3 13. 3 times is 39. So divide 12/6, you will get like 2. 2 7 times is 14. So if you add all these numbers, you will get 59/12. So then I'll be solving this part. So this is like 5, 2 half means 5/2, 1 1/6, we have already done it here. So it is like 7/6, 6 1/3, like 6 3 times is 18, plus 1 19/3. So again you can add the in the similar fashion, you will get 60/6. It is definitely 10. So again I have like assembled everything. Okay, so here in the first phase you get 59/12 and it is divided by 10 plus 1/120 as written in the question. So what I have done here is I have like made this like 59/12 divided by 10. So I had divided by 10. So you must be knowing that when this kind of situation arises, you can write it like multiply 1/10. So it will become 59 into 1, that is 59, and 12 into 10, that is 120. So you have 59 upon 120 and 1 upon 120. So you can add easily these two together. So you will get 60/120. So definitely these zeros will be get cancelled and 6 2 times is 12. So you get 1/2. So your correct answer is option D, half. So okay, so find the area of the shaded region of the given figure not drawn to scale. See, there can be two approaches to solve this question. So you can directly the first approach can be like directly find this area of this region and area of this region and add them to add both of them so that you can get the correct answer, because it is asked to find out the area of the shaded region. And the second approach can be like find out the total area of the biggest figure, which is like 90 into 80, which will be like let me just find it. 80 into 90 is equal to 7200. It is in centimeter, so it will be like centimeter square. Okay, so it is the area of the biggest rectangle. And what you can do is you can find the area of the white person and eliminate it from the biggest circle. So definitely you will get the area of the shaded area. So in here I will be like approaching the second strategy to find out the answer. So you can find the answer by first strategy, and let me know whether you did it right or not. Okay, so first of all, in order to find the area of this white person, I need to like divide it into like this. Okay, so let me connect this line and this line. So what will happen like this, I will be two identical figures here and here, and again I will have to find the area of this person. Okay, so let me try to find out the area of this. So area, to find out the area of this person, I need this one, which is given as 8, and the length up to here. So as you know, the total length is like 90 centimeters, so I have to cancel 20 centimeter from here. Okay, 20 centimeter from here, when cancelled it will give me 70 centimeters. So 8 into 70, that is 560 centimeter square or square centimeter. Okay, so one part is 560, then other part would definitely be 560, so it will become like 60 60 120, and 5 5 like 10 plus 1 11 20 square centimeter. So and here I need to find the area of this part. So one side is already given, that is 16 centimeters, so you need to find this part. So in order to find this part, you need to take the reference of this line, that is 80 centimeter. See, 80 centimeter, it has been shrinked over here 20 and then 8. So 28 from this side, and from this side also it is 8 and it is 20. So like it will be like 80 minus 2 into 28. So it is like 80 minus 2 into 28, like 56. It is like 56 plus 4 is 60 plus 20, it is 80. So it is 24. So it is 24 and it is 16. So I have to multiply it by 16. 16 4 times is like 64. 16 2 is 32 plus 6, that is 38 384. So I have to add. So this part plus this part is 1120, and the upper part is like 384. So I'll add 384 to it. I will get the area of the total white patch. Okay, so it is like 4 8 plus 2 is 0, 3 plus 1 4 plus 1 5, and it is 1. So 1504. So again, what I have to do is I have to subtract this 1504, okay, from this. So okay, so you can get the answer directly without subtraction also, because you have got 200. So and where you have got two zeros over here, and here you have 04, so definitely 96 will be the last two digits. So here you will get 5696 will be the answer. Okay, so you can do the whole subtraction and get it checked. So it is question number 49. So there are 4 questions combined, okay, in one single question. So okay, let us start with the first option. A fraction in which, it is asking about a fraction in which the numerator, suppose the numerator is there and a denominator is there, numerator is dash, then the denominator is called a proper. So it is asking about a proper fraction, and fortunately or luckily I have written a proper fraction in which you can say this 2 is less than the 5. So p can be less, smaller, like this. Okay, so you have got p options like greater, no, it can never be the answer, and smaller, yes, and greater, no. So either b or d can be our answer. So let us check the next option. Okay, so all the factors of a number q dash than equal to the number. So like it is asking, so let me just check all the factors of a number 4. You can see that all the factors are either less, that means the these two numbers are less than the number 4, and 4 itself is equal to 4. So we can say that all the factors of a number are less than or equal to the number, so it has to be less. Okay, so let us look the word less for the option Q. So less, it is less and it is less. So now with the combination of the answers P and Q, so you know this can't be our answer, though the answer for Q is correct. So again we find that both the options are correct in case of option B. So option B is our answer. So though we get our answer, still I'll be explaining all the other options. So let us check the question, like compare 0.75. Compare means either you can put a this sign or this sign, less than sign or greater than sign. So with the this number, that is 3/5 of that is 0.09. So if we'll check the base numbers, that is 0.75 and 0.09, so definitely it is much less than this number 0.75, and you are multiplying with a number which is a a proper fraction. When you multiply a proper fraction with a whole number, so definitely it decreases that number. So let me give you another example to verify it. Suppose you will be told to half of 12, so you can write half into 12, so definitely it will be 6. Suppose 1/3 of 15, it will be 5, so it will definitely decrease the given number. So definitely without worried about the answer, you can tell that this is much bigger than this number, so it will be greater than, and which is also satisfies the option B is correct. Okay, so let us discuss about the last part. So the line along which a figure is folded, such that two parts of the figure, suppose you have got a figure, and there is a line through which along which you can fold the figure, and it is called the line of symmetry. So if this is the line of symmetry, that means you will find two of the upper side are exactly identical, or you can say that both are mirror images. So it is the word you can use, exactly equal, identical, not similar, it is identical. So identical is correct, so it satisfies our answer. So it cannot be similar, it cannot be different, it can be identical, but we know our D cannot be the answer, okay, due to the option Q. Okay, so that's it. Jump on to the next question, that is 50. So find the value of P, P divided by Q multiplied by R plus S. Okay, so in order to find out the answer of this expression, we need to find out the variables first. Okay, all the 4 variables. See, if you need a number for P which when multiplied by 3 gives 5, so it is the only number 5 which will give a 5 when multiplied by 3, so that is P is 5. So we don't require to multiply 5 with all the numbers, as we are not given to find out any other number in this line. So let's jump on to the next line where we have to find out the value of Q. So see here, this line is the multiplication of 6013 with 9. So if we'll see 9 3 times is 27. Here it is written 7. So caret 2 and 9 1 time is 9 plus 2 is 11. So it has to be 1. Okay. So Q is like 1 and P is like 5. So let us jump on to the third line. So here it is the multiplication of 6013 with 2. So 6013 with 2, if you multiply straight away, the answer will be like 12026. So it has to be 12026. Okay. So definitely it is 2. Okay. And if you will add these two, you don't require to add all the numbers to come up this come up here. So you can see that is it is 5 is added to 2 is like 7 is written here. So you are not anything to carry over to this place. So definitely 1 you can just bring back here. So S is like 1. So let me write it on the expression so that we can find the value of the complete expression. So okay, so the value of P is like 5 divided by Q is like 1 multiplied by R is like 2. Okay, so plus S is 1 plus 0.00 and 2. Okay, so this 5 divided by 1, I have to I have to write it like 5 into 2, okay, plus 1 plus 0.002. So it will 5 into 2 will be like 10 and plus 1 will be 11 plus 0.002. It is a decimal number, it is a whole number. So if you will add, then it will give rise to 11.002. So you have to find 11.002. Is it there? Yes, it is in the option C. So this was the last question for this session. I hope you liked it and it will definitely help you to crack the Olympiad exams in the coming year. So if you really liked it, press the like button. And why you like this video, if you never liked it, so please comment on below so that I'll get motivated and I can change few things if you really didn't like something about my lectures. Okay, so do subscribe the video and share the video with your friends. That's it. Thank you and bye bye.